Anyways, I'm gonna be focusing to get to Murkwater Construction, and I'm over encumbered. That's why I gotta go back, actually. Do I have any, or did I not? No, I must have used it all. I gotta free up some space. Or I could take a buff. No, I'm gonna free up some space. Which I'll teach you a nifty little trick if you want to gain some extra space in your building size. I've seen it online. Some people know about it, some people don't. What you do is you drop stuff like these institution pistols. You drop weapons. This is the simplest way of doing it. You just dump out a bunch of stuff. You go into this, press B or whatever the equivalency is to store, and you put it in. You see the size meter goes down. Watch the size meter. See? Boom. And this works. This works really well. Like, you can build your settlements up to enormous sizes. I did this by accident. I didn't know about it at the time. I did this by accident on one of my playthroughs. And I'll tell you right now, if you do decide to do that, be careful, because you can break whatever area you do that in. And that's what happened. I broke the area. I didn't know why at the time. I learned about it later. Now, since I'm probably not going to come over here too often, I'm probably just going to use this as a bed like I just used it. I'm going to put in just a couple of these water pumps. And really, that's all I really need to do here. I might just double up on how much Tato they produce. Maybe put in above ground. Maybe put in a better supply line for them to grow like my other ones. I like to put all of my farms above the ground, because if the raiders or whatever gets past your front line, whatever they are, they will not get past, typically, they will not get past the turrets. If they get past the turrets, they gotta deal with the people. And that's where the real strength lies, is with the people. Oh, I did have some. Oh well. But that's where the real strength lies, is with your group. The noon will come. There we go. Yeah, we should be good to go. Anyways, I will be heading back to Sanctuary right now, but my plan, we're going to take Murkwater Construction, which is over here. Now, we got to go back. We got to talk to Preston. He's going to give us some XP, maybe some caps, and we're going to go back out on our merry way. Because where the vault is, I think it's 88. I think it's what it is. Where it's located is near Murkwater Construction, so I want to take that settlement early so I don't have to deal with it later. Now, next to this sign, there's usually maybe one or two radstags. Nope, none. Sometimes they're under the sign. Yeah, I capped one not too long ago, so that's probably why he's not here. Now, thicket excavation, I don't think it's been... Ah, yes it has, the raiders are here. I'm not going to go in there, but just to show you. There we go, some raiders and a turret. They moved in mighty quick. They moved in much faster than I imagined they would. We might come back and take them out. Might be some fun. Gain a little XP. I enjoy a good firefight, and really, it wouldn't hurt me too bad. Once you take them out, you got a nice little outpost here. But we're going to take, but we'll do that next time. Right now, we're going to go take over Murkwater Construction. We might go to the Quincy Ruins, though we won't be going into the town. We might go to where the DLC is going to be. We might go to the quarry. And we might take everybody out in the quarry so that when it comes down to it, we don't have to do too much to get in there. I swear, I do not remember these shutter doors being here. They feel new. Oh, the workhouse. You know what? There's one thing in the workhouse I want to show. I mean, it's not like anything tactical. It's nothing special as far as weapons go or anything like that. This is just something I stumbled upon. I just really, really like. Should take us back. No, it's not here. It's on the top floor. Yep, top floor. There it is. I like this little scene here. I really, really do. And it's just two guys fighting. How this happened, I have no clue. They were clearly fighting over whatever was inside the safe. And I just think it's funny. I would almost say this is possibly a Simpsons reference to Homer choking out Bart, but I don't know. It's like there's nothing else really in this place except for the safe and these two killing each other. It's really awkward. It's really weird. Like, this almost feels like it was something that they were going to do, but they didn't finish it, and I better not be walking into a gunfight right now. But it's one of the weird, quirky things that they got in this area that I noticed. That's pretty much it right there. We'll take this way. Sometimes there's some raiders. Yeah, there's none. We're good to go. I gotta break down some of the weapons I have. I gotta resupply a little bit. They need to patch their draw distance because that's sloppy. I really like the new stuff that they gave us with Far Harbor and the workshop. The contraptions workshop, I think the machinery stuff is cool. I think the elevators are neat. I think for the majority it's pretty neat stuff, but the one thing that I can't find a practical use for, and I've tried, is the ball and track system. Like, I haven't figured out how to use it. To the best of my knowledge, it's almost useless. I know there's some people who have worked it pretty well.
You know that settlement you sent me to help? They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the
job. Oh, Preston, how much I hate you.
You have one of these flare guns. You can use it to signal for help. Any nearby Minutemen. It'll get more and more useful as we get more allied settlements. Eventually, you'll have help wherever you need. I don't think I ever told you what happened to the Minutemen.
Yeah, I really don't care.
I figured you'd.
Have you heard of
Right? You guys came from Quincy.
That's right. I was with Colonel Hollis's group. You were the only.
We're just gonna speed through this because. It's dribble to me. I don't care for these guys too much. I never used Preston. I've never used Preston.
Okay. I'll do it.
Good. Don't worry.
That's quite a
the leader our last trip, the one.
Just because Preston will send you out on dumb side quests. Not that none of the other ones do, but oh, come on, don't be broken.
Uh-huh. Our scouts have found a promising spot, right. But nobody's gonna want it. Once you clear it out, before you know it.
And where is Preston? Taffington Boathouse. Yeah, we won't be doing that. That's complete opposite direction of where we're going. So, screw you, Preston. We're gonna go press on, do what we were planning to do. Hit my decon arch. There we go. I'm gonna dump the excess. Well, first I'll just break down the shit I have. Hopefully my traps have caught something. I don't use Fat Man's. Though something's telling me to carry this one, so maybe I will use this one. That's all the weapons. Huh, I thought there'd be more. There's some armor that I got. Yeah, which is this? Is this leather? I'll sell that shit. Yeah, some purified water. That is why you build that many purifiers. That is my currency right there. If I don't want to use anything else, I don't. I just use that stuff. I'll dump all but 60. Normally I do the whole thing of collecting and farming, but there's no point in doing that right now. I've got plenty of supplies, and when I get back I'll have more, so unless Carla's here, which even if Carla's here, I probably won't pick much up. Yeah, Carla's not even here. Let's see if the trap's got anything. Oh, one did. Alright. Got ourselves a rad stag. I could use some more meat. The reason why I chose rad stag as my prey is because their meat gives me a weight increase. So it increases my weight capacity, which is useful. So, out of copper, that's right. Alright. So having the added bonus weight capacity is very useful. Now, since I got a load of junk I need to get rid of, mainly some bonus weapons and armor and stuff like that, I'm gonna just dump it. I'll just dump it with the Drummond Diner. Unless that's Carla up ahead. No, that's just a Brahmin, a pack Brahmin. Yeah, I'm clearly fatigued. I'm being affected by fatigue. Sleep won't help though. I think that's how I got fatigued in the first place. But see, that's how I do my defenses. I have them spread out pretty good. I do have one or two of the little gunner posts, but I mostly just threw them out because you really can't do too much here defense-wise. And really, the higher the defense numbers, the better off you are. But going back to Deus Ex for a second, I think Mankind Divided is going to be pretty good. It looks very interesting. The gameplay has been greatly updated. The gunplay looks good. The augmentations you can get look really cool. I look forward to using whatever that stun cannon thing you can do where your arm morphs into a gun. That looks really cool. You got the little Tesla Wolverine claw things. Those look really neat. I really do look forward to playing it. I'm curious what choices they'll give you, if there's multiple endings to it, what the story's going to be. It looks like it's going to be something pretty solid. It looks pretty neat. The other thing I might be able to do sooner, I might be able to play some Mafia 3. I might be getting that game as well. I'll probably do a full walkthrough on Mafia 3. I never played Mafia 1 and 2. Of course, I should be keeping my guns up because there's always a raider here. There's just always two raiders here. Second one, where is he? There he is. Oh, you're gonna try and throw that Molotov, aren't you? Oh, there's three of you. Just as I predicted. The reason why I'm not taking so much damage is because the adamantium skeleton gives me a hell of a boost to my defense. Plus, I can't be crippled. Ah, Carla. Huh? Normally I pick up stuff from Carla, but time to do business? It's always time to do business with you, Carla. God, she, her eyes are so damn bloodshot. Alright, bottle cap mine. Yeah, we saw how good those mines really are. Flare gun. I'll keep it. Molotov. I have a plasma grenade. Let's dump this crap on you. I don't want it. Huh, only worth 19, really? I don't like drugs too much, but I will carry this stuff because it can be useful. Just about everything except for the damn sugar bombs are useful. Tar berries aren't that useful either, but every little bit helps right now. So getting to the Myrler construct, getting to the Murkwater construction, it's gonna be a walk. It's gonna be quite a walk. Matter of fact, I probably should have saved back there, but I'm sure I can find a bed on the way. I'm trying to think of any other places I can go to stay. I might be able to actually sleep here if there's people inhabiting the place. Change back to my shotgun. Oh, good. There's a chem vendor. Which means I might be able to get away with. Yep. Thank you, buddy. Appreciate it. Let's take a water. But yeah, I'll be probably covering Mafia 3. I didn't play Mafia 1 or 2. I did get to see the story, how the story played out, and I was very amazed by it. Reminded me very much of, the first one reminded me a lot of The Godfather, which I like. The second one, Goodfellas, which is one of my favorite movies. And this one, I'm very curious to see what they're going to do with the material. Are they, what's their plan with it? I mean, you're playing as a, pretty much a gangster during the 1960s in a New Orleans ripoff. I mean, it looks really interesting. I'm really curious what they're going to do with it. It might even be able to give GTA a run for its money. Then again, I am a little overhyped for it, so it could just as easily turn into crap. I'm hoping that's not the case. I really am. Because it looks like a pretty solid game. It's going to have some pretty good music into it. So hopefully it's going to be a good little ride. Another game I'm probably going to get my hands on will be Watch Dogs 2. I enjoyed Watch Dogs 1, so I see no reason to not to get Watch Dogs 2. It looks like they've improved greatly on the gameplay, the graphics, the new stuff you can do. You have anything? Nah, you have junk. So, it looks good. It looks really, really good. I look forward to this new character. Hopefully he's not an Aiden copy. Because I've had enough of Aiden Pierce. I liked Aiden, but I'm really hoping that this one brings someone new. Someone more interesting, more entertaining. Yeah, the mole rats I can hit. For the most part. God, this guy's gonna eat me. Normally I don't pick up everything, but I need as much food as I can get my hands on. Because I got a long trip into an alien environment. In this case, night's about to fall, so I'm gonna lose my health bonus, my radiation resistance bonus, and I'll be losing my health bonus and carry weight bonus. So hopefully I'll find another bed before then. But I'm hoping to cover a couple games this year. I might not be able to do a full walkthrough with them. For instance, with this, I'm going to continue doing my playthrough until I finish out the last of the DLC, which I probably won't be playing here because it takes so long for me to record. I will periodically be coming back to this series. For instance, the Borderlands series, I might continue until I get Deus Ex. It might end, though. I mean, it doesn't take too long to beat it. So I might be able to do it. It all depends on how much recording I can get done and how much I can get out. That's all. Because it takes well over a day. Our internet sucks. It takes well over a day for me to be able to get my videos out into the channel. So my videos are usually 2-3 days away. And I do all my recordings back to back. So it could take about a week for me to upload like 5 videos. I'm hoping to alleviate that sooner. I'm hoping to get hopefully faster upload speed. We'll see. But I do want to cover Deus Ex. I do want to cover Mafia 3. I want to cover Watch Dogs. And if I can, and the other ones I want to cover is I want to get the new Dead Rising. I love the Dead Rising series. I find them absolutely fun, absolutely funny. I want to cover those. The new South Park, that's supposed to be coming out, so that should be fun. I want to try and get those under my belt as well. So I'm going to be trying to stream fairly regularly now. I'm going to be trying to keep up my videos on at least trying to get up as many videos as I can per week. Now, there might be some times where I won't be able to upload for a week at a time, maybe. It's usually because I haven't been recording. But I'm going to try and be as consistent as possible. Yeah, you're a scavenger. I don't think you'll attack. Nope, you will. I hate scavengers. Because they fall somewhere in the middle. Is there a vertebrate around here or something? Okay, I think I just saw. Oh, a robot! Mr. Gutsy, does this mean there's more robots? Or is that it? I know I'm walking into some kind of danger right now. But I'm trying to develop a consistent pattern, you know. I'm new to this, so I'm trying to keep my consistency up. So please, if you like what you're seeing, or if you have any suggestions, please let me know. You know, if you like what you see, hit the like. If you want to see more, subscribe. It's really up to you. Right now I'm sort of just experimenting, finding what I like to do. Later on down the line, I'm probably gonna get a camera. I'm probably gonna start doing some filming around the local neighborhood. You know, it's an evolving process right now. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna be smart, and I'm gonna sleep for 12 hours. But if you want to see more Fallout, if you want to see the survival series finish out, which will be pretty much, I want to take this character through all of the DLC. I want to cover the Caravan Guard, where the hell is Cricket? You know, I want to cover the DLCs. I want to cover maybe the main story. I've never quite covered the main story. I've done it, but I never like finishing the main story, to be honest, because I lose out on being able to use all three of those groups. But if you want to see a complete walkthrough, let me know. If you want to see something else, like more Borderlands, I also have Red Dead Redemption. I'm probably going to move into Red Dead Redemption soon, now that it's backwards compatible. I mean, I have a long library list of games. I don't have to just play open world RPGs. I can play third person action. I could go back through GTA, which would be fun. So just leave me some suggestions. If I have the game, I'll gladly play through it if you want to see that. For right now, I'm just running through my Fallout, enjoying the wastelands. Because I could play this game all day. I like the way the world is. I've always liked how Fallout is. Which I could even play Fallout 3 or New Vegas if you've never got to experience those. Those are terrific games. I recommend them to everybody. And really, this is what I wanted to find. I wanted to find the railroad tracks. Because these railroad tracks go straight to the Murkwater construction. Or it goes as close as possible to it. So I'm going to use this place for it. There's usually something in there. Yeah, feral ghoul. I have no reason to do this. I'm just doing it because I want the extra XP. I'm trying to get that bonus level. There's usually a meaner son of a bitch in that water. I guess he's not there. And I'm not going down there. Oh, where is it? I know it's near these railroad tracks. I think that's it over there. I'm going to check. Because there's an interesting little Easter egg in this game that goes back to Fallout. Oh, shit. I don't like that thing. I really, really don't. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. I didn't want to wake this thing up. Okay, remember that fat man I was telling you about? Fuck it, we're using it. Because I am not fighting this thing. Oh, shit, that didn't kill him. Okay. Let's think. Some jet, first off. I wish this was a kneecapper. Run. Yeah, I did not want to take him on. He's a beast. But I get some fusion cores out of it. Actually, I'll just take everything. Yeah, that's it. I'll go check that out. I'll show you guys this one. I like this little Easter egg. It's really cool. If you play Fallout 3... What the hell is that? What's with the blue glow? That was weird. Like a blue flame. Oh, it's an arc. Okay. Good to know. I thought it was like a fire or something. Anyways, if you've played Fallout 3, this is a really cool Easter egg. Okay, Yogi. You and Boo Boo get the fuck away from me. Wish to God Ranger Smith was here. First, I'll take that medics. I know this seems a bit excessive, but when you need health. And, goodbye, boo-boo. Anywho. As I was saying before, I was rudely interrupted by those sons of bitches. If you've ever played Fallout 3, and you played through the story, you had to go to a little place called Tranquility Lane. And this is Tranquility Lane. I don't know if this is canon or not. I really don't know, and that music's playing because there's a ghoul trying to kill me. He's up in that house. I'll probably go get him. This place here is Tranquility Lane. It's got the nice little swing set area, the nice little cul-de-sac. Of course it goes out, but this is Tranquility Lane. It's not a perfect recreation, but this is possibly the inspiration for the original Tranquility Lane in Fallout 3. Nifty little bit of information there. Now, how you get in here is... Because I want to get this ghoul because I want to use the workbench. I can't use it unless I go in here and kill them. And that's how you get in there. Now you can find a way to unchain it. I forget how to do it. Oh, this guy's a regular Home Alone. Pulse grenade. That could have came in handy earlier. Let me see. Yeah, I'm not going to use these. Though the pulse mine I'll keep just in case I run into another one. Yeah, this guy was packing. He had enough stuff here for a siege. He was pretty well and ready to go. Now, I probably barred it up. Oh, crap, a glowing one. Okay, let me be smart about how I do this. This was not smart at all. I go down the stairs. The door's rigged. Can't activate the rigged door. That sucks. Alright, that does away with that. This guy was ready for anything. Let's remove that door tension. There we go. We own this place now. The old Reaver. I actually miss Fallout 3's Reavers. In the Broken Steel DLC, they put the Reavers in. And what the Reavers were in Fallout 3 were way meaner than what they are in Fallout 4. These ones are like pussies in comparison. Because the ones in Fallout 3, they would throw like balls of radiation energy. It looks really cool. Because they would just have these energy projection abilities. And they would just soak up every bullet. They were just mean motherfuckers.